and now I'm able to iterate over args variable and sum all values of those integers. Let's do that here. Let's first define new variable total, and its initial value will be 0. Now let's iterate over arguments, and you could iterate using for syntax: for arg in args colon, and here let's do following: total plus equal arg, and finally let's return total. In a moment I'll explain to you what happens here. Now let's just run this code, and I see result 32 here in the output. So what happens here? Here on this line we iterate over arguments. Every value of container type is iterable. We just saw here that args is tuple, and that's why we are able to iterate over elements of the tuple. Let's here inside of the for in loop first print to the terminal arg. Let's run the code, and I see 5, 2, 10, 15, and finally I see 32, that is the result of this function call here. And it means that inside of the for in loop there is variable called arg, and that's actually where this variable is defined, and we are able to perform some actions with such variable. In this example it is integer, and to this line we increment value of the variable total that was defined here by arg using plus equal operator, and after this for in loop value of the total variable will contain sum of all arguments, and that's why here when we return total we get sum of all arguments passed in this function call. If I remove this line and add for example one more element here, let's add 10, run application again, I get 42. And it doesn't matter which quantity of arguments here you pass in this function call, all of them will be summed up here in this for in loop. Now let's talk about keyword arguments. Let's remove all of that from here, and let's define again function called person underscore info, and here recap we use the two parameters name and age, and let's print to the terminal name and age, like that. Let's here call this function person info with two arguments, Bob and 25, like we did before. Let's now run this application, and I get Bob and 25. But what if you want to have variable quantity of parameters here, not just two like name and age? And let's say that you want to extend this function and you want to add other parameters, for instance city, country, hobbies and so on. But not in all function calls all arguments must be present, and you want to have ability to call this function, let's say, only with two arguments, name and age. But in some cases you want to call it with more arguments, for instance name, age and city. How to accomplish such task? You could use keyword arguments, and syntax is following: two stars args, like that. Let's here print to the terminal args. Let's save changes, run application, and now I get type error: person info takes 0 positional arguments but 2 were given. This means that with such syntax in parameter section here, you are not allowed to use positional arguments like you see here on this line in this function call. You must use only named arguments or keyword arguments. Let's modify these arguments from positional arguments to keyword arguments. Here will be name, and here will be age, like that. Let's now run application, and now I get dictionary with two keys, name with value Bob and age with value 25. This means that with such syntax in place, arguments, keyword arguments, are automatically converted to dictionary. Let's basically ensure that it is dictionary. Let's print type of the args and run application. And yes, I see class dictionary. And now here inside of this function, you are able to work with args variable same as you work with any dictionary. You could access keys, you could add new keys, you could modify values of the keys and so on. For instance, you could print only args, square brackets, name, like that. And now you'll get value of the name key in this dictionary. It is Bob in this example. Also, let's add here city. For instance, Paris. and now I'm able to access city, like that. Let's run and I get Paris. But what if city is not passed here as keyword argument? What I'll get? I'll get error, and error is key error city. And that's what we discussed before. If you attempt to access specific key in the dictionary using square brackets notation and such key is absent in the dictionary, you'll get key error. If key might be present and might be not, you need to use get method. Like that, args.get. And here will be city. If I run code now, I'll get none. Because that's that value that is returned by get method if specific key is absent in the dictionary. And now in this function call there is no keyword city, and that's why in this args dictionary there is no key city. And certainly if you want, you could assign default value to this absent key, for instance New York. And now I'll get New York here on this line. That's keyword argument feature that is represented using two stars and name of the variable. Of course, name here could be any you like, not necessarily args. For instance, we could change it to person, and let's modify it here, here and here, and type person instead of args. Rerun code and I see exactly the same result. Alright, that's it for keyword arguments in Python.